two dead corpses, a gun, a girl, and a chain of dramatic events that have led to this moment. I could tell you.
But then, I'll have to kill you.
To everyone, we were a normal family. The perfect housewife. The successful businessman. The obedient child. Behind closed doors, we told a different story. Victim, the abuser, the powerless.
Tolong datang sekarang, Cik. Bini saya dia bunuh diri. Ya, Cik. Nombor 18. Jalan 5. Tolong datang sekarang, Cik. Ya. Ya, dia. Ya, saya tunggu.
This is where I spend the rest of my life. My stepdad managed to convince people I was in a boarding school. And as the years passed, everyone forgot he ever had a child. Even in a crowd of kids, I felt so alone and unwanted.
make you remember what you did to me 15 years ago!
After being 3 years sober, I adapted into society. Life was simple. Wake up, go to work, be good. I jumped into a routine like most of us do, and have never looked back. Free time that I have sparingly, I seem to have adopted an interest in someone, you might say. Trust me, it's not what you think. She reflected something of my past life that I am not too proud of. Fate can be a dangerous thing. There she was. God had sent her right to me.
Glass of water.
So close.
The bathroom is filthy.
Yeah, sorry, keep you waiting. You wanna get out here?
Yeah, sure. The peacefulness of the town. When my mom was battling cancer, I remember she would be asleep during this time, but I was wide awake. I knew she didn't have much time, so at savor any moments I came to be with her. I would watch her sleep and listen to her breathe. Until one day, she just stopped.
Sorry, Jenna.
Don't be. I was privileged enough to tell her that I loved her every day, and I did all I could to ease her sufferings. So your parents are out?
Well, my mom was actually shot by my dad when I was 10. And I thought, hey, why don't I repay the favor? So, I counted the three and put a bullet in him.
Car accident. The old man had it coming, drinking and drinking. Eventually took my mom along.
Sorry to hear that. And I thought my life was depressing.
You can say today is certainly a highlight of my so-called depressing life.
Glad to hear it.
Everything okay?
Yeah. I just thought I heard something drop by there. It's been nice, Professor, but I must be off.
Wait. Oh, when can I see you again? Same place tomorrow?
Yeah. I'll see you.
I needed to get close to her. Close enough to end my legacy. Some might say I was a different person back then.
Run, boy, run. This world is not meant for you. Run, boy, run. They're trying to catch you. Run, boy, run. Running is a victory. Run, boy, run. Beauty lies behind the hills. The sun will be guiding you. Run, boy, run. They're dying to stop you. Run, boy, run. This race is a prophecy. Run, boy, run. Break out from society. Tomorrow is another day, hey. And you won't have to hide away, yeah. You'll be a man, boy. Journey to run, boy, run. The secret inside of you. Run, boy, run. This race is a prophecy. Run, boy, run. And disappear in the trees.
I needed to get to her before they got me. I was a vigilante in my mind, taking away aggressors who reminded me of my father. I was trying to protect the world, but only to understand. I took away a father, brother, and a son with my quick judgments. I was even dubbed to the world as the three-strike killer, marking each body with three axes. Three strikes and you're out, was my philosophy. She looks perfectly harmless. Katie. She lacked finesse or motive. Beautiful girl, rich family, educated. But yet, she mimics my art with no substance. Body found in Kuala Lumpur with three axes marked on it. The only problem is, it wasn't me. You need to kill her, Xavier.
So smooth, Professor.
You're right, thank you. You need to kill her, Xavier. You need to. Understand each other without words. She was beautiful.
Professor, I think I'm in love with you.
The last time I heard those words or ever replied was when my mother gave her last good night.
Today is the day you're gonna end things once and for all. You gotta do it.
Sorry, I'm late.
Why are you late?
It's a surprise.
Can I trust you?
Can I trust you? No, man, trust me.
This was my moment, putting an end to my legacy, once and for all. I had her, all I needed was to pull the trigger. But then, I don't know what came over me, that hair. Those eyes, that smile. I froze.
Why are you standing there? Come on!
I can't believe it. Katie wasn't like the other girls I knew. She was smart and strong. We had so much in common that meets the eye. For instance, she murdered those who reminded her of her mother's doctor. She said that they could have done more for her. She killed those she thought were arrogant and selfish. After every murder, my hands would tremor. She would always cry. We both felt we were misunderstood vigilantes in the world. If your heart won't let you kill them, join them. I guess I loved her too.